Okay, now we all know how Pacific people totally dominate most sports.
And now we can add water polo to the list.
Yeah, you would think it would be rare to find Polynesians competing in water polo, let alone competing at the Olympics.
But two Niuean brothers from Wellington are set to change all this, as Nikki Sialepa discovers.
Whakalofalahiatu people, I'm down here in a not-so-windy Wellington, Nainai to be exact. Now, a little bird told me that I might be able to find a couple of islanders down here who not only play water polo representatively, but who own a pair of Speedos. Ha! Yeah, right. If that's true, I'll get in a pair. Excuse me. Guys. Hi. Are you guys Niuean? You are? Oh, hey, I'm doing an interview with you guys today. Do you want to come out and we'll have a chat? Yeah, sweet. Awesome.
Whakalofalahiatu, my name's Eamon.
And I'm Connor.
And we're the Louis Fuggles from the Narva Brothers.
Representing Niue.
So this little water polo thing, now, how hard is it? It can't be that hard. It looks easy. Look, there's kids in the water.
Nah, mate, it's tough. It's real hard.
Yeah, it's pretty hard. Do you want to give it a go then?
Yeah, I'll give it a go.
Ah, sweet. Let's jump in.
Let's do it.
I can do that. Okay, let's do it. Let's do this pool thing. I'm ready. I've got my lava in my bag. I should go and get it, I think. Lava? That's cool. They're cool with it, no?
Speedos.
Natural, mate. Natural.
Definition of real togs, that's Speedos. Even Kanye West, he raps about being the man in a pair of Speedos.
Yeah, that tuxedo might have been a little Guido, but with my ego, I can stand there in a Speedo.
Ow.
I started maybe when I was about 8 or so. Our older sister is a couple of years older than me. She used to play when she was little and we just sort of followed her and we swam when we were little kids.
Mum and Dad always took us to the pool, so it seemed natural that we followed to the game, mate.
What is water polo? Short explanation.
Well, pretty much it's almost like a cross between soccer and basketball in the pool. Like you're trying to score a goal at the other end. So you swim around and throw this ball around and yeah, trying to beat the defense to score a goal. Well, we've been pretty lucky. Like we've got to have some pretty good tournaments overseas. Like we've had World League and Junior World Championships, and
it's just pretty sick hearing your name called out in the lineup, but you hear your last name twice because there's two of you, so
yeah.
That's cool. Pretty sick.
There's a few more islanders playing now. Like when we first started, there wasn't too many brown bodies floating around in those Speedos. But
you need to get the strength and the size that the rugby boys have, get them in the water, get them chucking the ball, and I reckon we'll dominate.
Excuse me, can you take the towel off? Not out the towel. I've never been a Speedo.
No, there's always going to be a bit of a scrap going on, but like you have to fight for
it's
position,
just part
so
of it.
That's how you get position, like under the water grabbing. Or
I've been split open, spent a night in hospital, been coughing up blood and stuff from stray knees and stuff like that.
What,
and
to the head?
Yep.
Heaps of our mates, like boys and girls, through water polo, so we just get to hang out. Like when we come to training, we get to hang out with our mates.
It's like twice a day, every day, pretty much. Maybe one day off. But it's pretty full on, so social life's usually to a minimum during the season. But it's all right.
Tom, do you wear Speedos?
No.
Don't lie, you're wearing them now, eh? Good luck to both Connor and Eamon, who are currently training with the New Zealand men's team for the Commonwealth Cup in March 2010.